At the moment, he says, isn't there hardly a bush to be got in the place? And he's in that area very stunted.
Yeah.
But the original name that you had, Carrickeen, might have some more.
Now that's the type of thing that's going on.
That's right.
No longer somewhere would be the
fourth. That's right. That's one of them. That's the fair one. And that's the new one to the road, isn't it?
Donovan of 1838 says he came from Clever, C-R-I-L-B-H-A-F-C-H, meaning Leafy, Albussy Land. Now there are many Clevers from town names named from that in Ireland. Today there are very few trees to be found here, just a few stunted hedges. In 1838 it contained over 651 acres, including 290 acres of uncultivated land. It was owned by Charles Knox of Castle Lacken. Tenants had it 6 shillings an acre. There were 36 families here. They grew crops of oats, flax and potatoes. It had a signal tower back here, and the village of Clever down here. In 1856, the immediate letter of it was still Colonel Charles Knox. Sir William Roger Palmer, the baronet, had over 132 acres of it, leased from him. The townland of Snow, he owned it, I should have said. The townland, our tenants were Anthony Tagg, Martin Thomas, or Thomas, Bridget Tagg, John Craft, Anthony Healy, Michael Healy, Thomas Lyon, John Lyon, John Kelly, John Flanley, Martin Tagg, Bartholomew Timpany, John McCabe, Catherine Tagg, Patrick Welch, and Colonel Charles Knox. In 1641, it was called Carrickeel, the townland, and the townland proprietor was the Earl of Cork. This here was called the tower.
Yeah.
None of you ever saw it standing, did you?
No.
Any idea what it was built? Yeah, well, O'Donovan in his notes has it down in 1838 as a signal tower. Now, I suppose, have you any idea what it would be signaling, you know, or what was the purpose of this tower being here at all now?
Well, I heard about it as it was in case of the French landing again.
Yeah.
And then it had to come again. That these places were built for to watch the coast for it. To give it a
fall. But there's a great view of it.
Eh?
There is.
Yeah.
All kinds of land. They could sight all shipping coming in and going out.
Mm-hmm.
You were telling me there that your father had something about this tower years ago.
Well, a month ago it fell.
Yeah.
The father was standing in the door looking out. Today a big wind. And the world people are looking at, he said the tower is down.
The tower is down. How long ago, Tom, would you think that was? 140 years ago. Couldn't be 140 years ago. It'd be 120 years ago, would it? So that shed down there with the red tin on it, that's where your father lived?
Yes, that's
So he'd be one of the nearest men to the towers to see you there. Yeah. Yeah. Now I thought this was a round tower, but you were telling me that you thought it was a square building or a rectangle. Yeah. 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 You didn't hear what height it was? Or was
no,
it height?
That was where they used to have the flagstaff.
The little mound there, the flagstaff. Oh, yeah. Yeah. The tower is there behind us now, and I believe there were soldiers in it at one time.
Yes, there were soldiers.
How many did you hear, didn't you?
Well, two, I heard. Yeah. Anyway, I heard one fact about them. They went away drinking one night. And they came home, they were hungry. And there was bacon and cabbage. A pot of bacon and cabbage. Very common for their dinner.
Right.
So it was this stuff, plates, mushroom, fish, soup, and it was this stuff on one plate and one dish. Father and they got them pleased. But anyway, one of them, he wasn't too happy with the milk on the farm. The next step in the use of the mat, I couldn't tell you, but anyway, he threw them away and he died with the finger.
Yeah.
So the other fellow had a good hefty knife. When he got the hand come up to the plate the same, he gave the hand and he left the four fingers on the plate.
Well, that'll be one of his mates, one of the soldiers.
Well, they used to have the houses down in Stobner Moor below there.
Where was that now? Down the village?
Just below there on the bus at Kelly Council.
Oh, good.
Yeah, the old stable.
From the baker town.
Was it? Yeah.
I was told that this was that thing father.
Now, that concrete what we see back there is a well. Now, it had its name and history attached to it, hadn't it? Didn't it? The well of the soldiers. And the soldiers you have in mind, the soldiers they had in mind at the time were the soldiers that lived up here in the tower. Was there ever an attack or anything there on it?
No, nothing there on it.
Quite people live in here. They never poisoned the well or anything on them, did they?
No.
They were all peasants.
Oh, yes. Yes. Yeah. Tim houses over there now. They're in.
I was past the Rohan.
Was it?
You cannot see the Rohan. There are big mountains stones in the middle.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. But these houses there in the background, they were in Flybrook.
Yes.
Oh, they are in Flybrook, aren't they? So there's no townland today as Flybrook since, I believe, 1838. It's called Creaver.
Yeah.
So this is the townland boundary of Flybrook that has disappeared.
Yeah,
exactly. Yeah, it disappeared.
And it goes all the way right down to the sea.
Yeah. This bit here is the one.
Yes, that's the one.
So it was a long, narrow townland, wasn't it?
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. And that one now has disappeared from history.
I'm standing on the site of the flagstaff. It used to be here when this tower was in action. And all these towers had a site like this, had a spot where they had a flagstaff. And from this point, they used to signal to the other signal towers around the coast. Probably one more back then going traffic in here. They were using flags in the old semaphore system. I think during those days, there was no telephone or the like of radio. So the one guy stood here with a pair of flags, and he passed on a message to the guy behind who was sitting there with a telescope, I suppose it could be in those days, taking it down, and he gave it to the guy next to who was gotten it down, and stay in turn and pass it on to another signaling station.
Yeah.
Eventually pass inland to some headquarters.
Yeah.
If they sighted anything else here, whatever information was going on.
So there were signal information from here?
No information, very quickly too.
Yeah.
Each system of flag number and second level of the alphabet.
Yeah.
It's called a
semaphore. Yeah.
Now, this is the flag group. This is the flag group over here. On Lerka, as was known in the olden days.
Yeah.
It gave its name. Well, the stream is the river itself, and you can see from the bottom of the sort of the bottom flag.
Yeah.
River flag.
So the flags are there and the brook is there.
The brook is there.
The brook is the river.
It gave its name to the townland which has disappeared off the Admiral Survey.
Yeah.
And I don't even think they recorded it included it in Cleaver.
flag goes.
Yes, the tradition and everything else. The homeland same flag goes here between Dinadoba and Silver.
Right.
Now all the land on this side of it, on this side of the river is Silver, now known as Silver. And on this other side of it here is Dinadoba.
Yes. So the river is the boundary?
The river is the boundary between the two towns.
Going all the way down to the sea?
All the way down to the sea. See that old house that fell in up there?
Yeah.
Well, that was what the man that lived there was a man named Pat Healy, the name was Pat Jean Healy. And that was his old house. Now there's one fort, since you see the corner was sticking out there to the left of us.
Yeah.
And there's another one further down the field here, down on top of the rise. You can't see very much of it here, but that's about the location.
One of these gave its name to Dinadoba, I think.
One of them gave its name to
Dinadoba.
Yeah. The only fort you can find in the area.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, Barry, there was an old house here you were talking about.
Yes. And there was a man there called Sean Herbert.
Yeah.
And there was an old woman there, and she was in care of the slave children, looking after the slave, so the people were calling the farmer her cruiser. And this man decided to kill her, so he killed her one. And that finished the slave on the...
Yeah, pulling of the cruiser, was it?
Pulling of the cruiser.
Yeah. Well now, the people here, like, they owned part of the shore down there, was that it?
Well, I don't know that they owned the part of the shore, but she wasn't charged anyway.
That's
the landlord
or somebody.
It does. And they had her anyway for preventing the
people. So it's all about pulling the cruiser, as they call it, or the crane off down
with
the shore.
Off the shore.
Yeah.
And this man decided to kill her.
Well, did they have to pay her or give her something if they wanted to pull it or what?
Well, no, because she wouldn't allow anyone
to pull it. I see.
She wouldn't pay compensation.
Yeah. Sean Heather, that would be his mother or his wife?
Well, I don't know what her name is.
Yeah. Across the river there is Dinadoba, and your father was telling you about an eviction that took place over there, let's say, 100 years ago.
Yeah, it was back in
the day. Can you tell me something about the eviction, or who was evicted there?
Well, there was a family that McGovern was evicted.
Yeah.
And I believe other families as well that I don't know anything about.
Yeah.
But he told me that this family McGovern were evicted, and the teacher that was in Killeen,
yeah,
a man named Nathan Jewell,
yeah,
let the scholars over to see the eviction.
Yeah.
And they threw everything outside the house, the goose and the gander and the chickens and everything else, and set fire to the house.
Yeah.
Over the English police.
Did they use a basket around the back or down the door?
That's what I don't know, but yeah, they didn't say that.
Yeah.
Well, it was before Mr. Anderson.
That would be before Mr. Anderson. Before Mr. Anderson. Nearly here is land.
Nearly here is land. And the right inside the road over
here? Yes. Yeah. Just where the gate is. Just behind the gate, you can see. There must be a crack in the house there.
Yes, I can see it.
Yeah. Well, we've got two forts here. This is one of them. It doesn't look much of a fort today, does it?
No, I don't.
And the road has probably gone through half of it.
I wish you'd have heard me pass the one in this side, because there was a double in. There was a double in. No,
sir. Oh, there's a ring around here.
Yeah.
And there's one on the outside. Single ring.
Mm.
Yeah. So what's the one or other of these two forts here that must have given Dinadoba the name? There's no fort in Dinadoba. This is the village of the old village of Flagbrook, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Now in Cleaver.
Now here we have a road that goes nowhere. It's coming from nowhere and it's going nowhere. Nobody seems to know very much about it. Whether it was a famine relief work or what it was. But if it was a famine relief work, I'm surprised that there isn't more known about it. It's laid out. Of the road, you know, that was built
around here at the time.
Yeah. It's laid out the main stone deck here in the middle. Then you had a fence and you had a drainage provided on each side. It was more unusual in those days. They nearly always relied on natural drainage, and they were here, there and everywhere. But these were specially for drainage. It's laid out more or less on the lines, roughly on the lines of the old Roman road, same type of structure.
Yeah.
So you had a cross deck of stone and you had two drainage passages on each side.
Yeah.
Continues on. The stones were spread on it here, but they're not here. So the stones were never spread here. This is just what they spread out. They're spread half of the way over there, and the mountain stones are left broken in the middle in other places where they were never spread.
Never finished. Kind of an unfinished road.
Yeah. The station's supposed to bypass all the bins, come out behind them side roof and go across and through the park and come out beyond the general range and that kind of thing. It could happen, but take that line. It could cut out most of the bins that we know on the road to be.
Yeah.
Whatever happened to it,
never. Would it cut out the tower head? Make it easier on the horses.
Oh, yeah. It's nearly perfectly flat to it.
Yeah.
It's a good forerunner of your modern, modern motorway.
Engineering work too, wouldn't it?
It's well laid out engineering work.
Yeah.
It's laid out, well, we should be laid out basically on half. The railway life had to be laid out in those days. It
would have been going in this direction too, wouldn't it?
Off, yes. It was supposed to come out behind the flagboat.
Or the river?
Yeah, well, some say at the river when it's lost, it said that it's come out behind the river here the south. It made it even a better job, so it would be safer.
Yeah. So this is the town on the flagboat, isn't it?
Now this place where they're sitting up here is called Stirling. Any old outcropper in Ireland with a crag face on it is generally referred to as crag, and there's several of them all over the place. This is the name of the zone.
Coming there, you're standing on an old road.
Yes.
The old bog road. Wasn't called that, was it? What did you call it?
Oh.
Where was it? Oh, this was the original road from Rumadova, wasn't it? Here, there, there.
Right.
Yeah. Where did it come out?
That's called Memorial.
Oh, I see.
That's beyond the center.
That's at the Creever.
That's the bridge.
Yeah. In the Creever village.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then this was used up until what time? Oh, yeah.
The
super tower.
Yeah.
That's it, that old. Yeah. So this is Shanbourne. This is the tower road here,
yeah,
isn't it?
Bohara tower.
Yeah. So on the left there, Tom, or on the, yeah, on my left, it'll be on your right. There was a heap of stones one time, wasn't there?
Yes, come on.
Yeah.
It used to be called the afterbath, and that was just trying to clear some of the ground.
Yeah. Big with a big stone. So this left the barn was each side of the road, wasn't it?
Yeah, each side of the road.
Yeah.
Because all one is what looks like.
Oh, I see, yes. So it had the name before the road was built here.
The last of it back on the other side of the Achterbourne. You can trace it along there by the fences that you can see. It was laid out in the bed of a river. This was customary in those days because landlords compelled the locals to travel in riverbeds and whatever. They didn't like them traveling through the land on roads. So this is what you had to put up in those days.
Comfortable saddle on that kind of a road.
It was a very rough surface, but then people were used to that sort of thing though. This is the Tower Road, it's known the other side, this side is known as the Tower Road, on the other side is the Achterbourne.
Quarry up there, isn't it?
There is, there's quarry on both sides of the tower actually. You have the white stone, free stone quarry on this side, on the other side is the coloured stone. You get the quarries and they go about 10 feet of broken stone on top of the main bedrock. And you quarry those, but when you get down to the bedrock, that's it, you won't quarry that side except you just get it nice. These are the places they used to call the Gori Bebe. Now there must have been a village here, although there's no tradition of there having been any village in it. But there's enough stones there to build a very big village. Thrown around in fences and sort of bits of walls of houses and whatever. There must have been a habitation there at one time, whatever became of it.
Now here is
Stoblemore.
Standing behind you here now, Minnis, it's called Stoblemore. Yeah. Why do they call that, anyone know? The big stable.
The big stable. Was where the soldiers used to have their horses.
Soldiers over in the tower?
The tower.
Yeah.
And that was the door, right?
That one there.
Yeah.
You didn't ever hear how many horses they had?
Well,
they
didn't know.
Or any legends about the horses?
Legends about the horses, that was Stoblemore, more the soldiers used to have their horses.
Yeah. Now, besides this here too, lived a doctor of a sort, wasn't it? The Seventh Son.
The Seventh Son, yeah.
That was John Clifford. Yeah. 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 He had cures for ringworm. Anything else?
Well, I don't know anything else.
I think that's about all.
And he travelled the length and breadth of Ireland, couldn't he?
Did he?
Down to Kerry and to Cork and different places when he was in England.
Did he then?
I often haven't done that. He used to want to train his mother.
Yeah. Would people send for him or what?
Well, it must be that they would send for him.
Yeah.
And he chose the fellow that came a few years ago, maybe 4 or 5 years ago. Not too long ago, but anyway. Yeah. He was married to Franklin Avery's daughter in America.
Yeah.
And he tried all the hospitals and doctors in New York. And he had ringworm all over the body, and John Clifford told me that he never saw what shape.
Yeah.
And he came to him on a Monday, and he rubbed his hand on me, you know, whatever it
is. Yeah.
And on Thursday he could see an improvement.
Yeah.
But when he had finished with him, came again on Thursday, and then on the next Monday, and he had finished with him, he was quite all right.
Yeah. He cured on a bus too, I think, yeah.
It is.
Second year with him, Michael, I think.
Michael, yeah. Yeah, yeah,
he was good, all right.
He was. Well, I was telling that to Tom Odey, and he was laughing, he was, he keep laughing with
him. He didn't believe it.
He didn't believe it. Well, yeah. I said, the only way you believe it, I said, is going to be tonight.
Is that the house there?
Yes,
it's here.
So was it? Was it a carpenter shop?
It
was. And one carpenter that was working there, was it a few?
There was two. Four of them before.
Who were the Healy's were there?
Yeah.
Yeah. What were they turning out?
Boat.
Oh, yeah.
There were boat rights and wheel rights. Wheel rights and boat rights.
And carpenters. And cotton makers.
And cotton makers.
Now, someone said there were coopers making barrels, were they?
There were making cotton and barrels and boats. There were boat rights and wheel rights.
Yeah, good tradesmen.
Yes.
You saw them, Roger, did you?
Yeah.
I often heard my mother talking about them there, but Mihal and Paul.
Yeah.
And they made cotton for anybody there around the place. They had to
they made cotton.
Did they? Yeah, yeah. How long ago since they were working down here?
They went into the bag and they never cared for me.
Did they not?
No.
Yeah.
A couple of years ago, eh? Went
40 years ago. 40 years ago they were working here. So you saw the roof on the workshop and the things.
Oh,
there.
Yeah. Yeah. And the maids.
The
maids.
They had the same saw. They saw their own thing.
Did they?
I made the best of furniture.
Did they?
Oh, it's nearly all furniture.
Yeah.